Welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to talk about something very interesting. We're going to talk about Valentine's Day gift ideas for ladies. So this time we're going to talk about ladies. Next time we're going to talk about ideas for a man for this occasion. I know not everybody is actually buying gifts for Valentine's Day, but I think like some people might think that it's very, very commercial, that it's no point to spend money or something like this. But for me, if there is an occasion that you actually can celebrate love, then why not to do it? So if you are not so much against, then have a look what kind of gifts are actually very, very elegant for ladies. So first one, which is very, very big classic and probably you're not going to be surprised, is to buy for your lady a perfume. And perfume obviously is very, very personal thing. So I would say if you already are in a relationship or if you know someone well, then buy the perfume that they like, they use. If you are on the beginning, let's say dating, and you're not sure what kind of perfume you can buy, then just go something for it's very, very feminine. Something that you actually like and something that you want your lady to smell like. So this is going to obviously be a hint for her as well, that if you bought this kind of perfume, then obviously you like them and you want her to use it. And ladies are more of the time, they are flexible and obviously they want to please their partners as well. I have here, if you don't have completely idea what kind of perfume to buy, then I have here a list that you can actually use it. And I think that very, very nice are Chloe perfume. If you want to go for Chanel, you can buy Mademoiselle. Those are very, very feminine. If you want, because obviously the most popular Chanel are number 5, but I would say not every lady is going to like it and not every lady is going to smell nice when they are going to touch their skin, because obviously perfume going to change depends on the woman's skin as well. So I would Mademoiselle from Chanel is very, very nice perfume, and I feel like it's very youthful as well. So it doesn't really matter how old the lady is, I think those are really nice. The new one, the perfume C, they are very, very nice as well. And obviously there is more, and I'm going to put the list here so you can just, if you don't have an idea what kind of perfume to buy, then one of those, I'm sure it's going to be really, really nice. Another very, very classic idea, and I want to talk about elegant and classic gifts, because you know, you can buy a lot of different things if you know someone very, very well and you know that your partner is missing something, then obviously you can buy that. But I just want to talk a little bit about more romantic, more like elegant gifts that ladies love for this kind of occasion. So second on our list is a jewelry, but I'm not going to talk about all jewelry. I just feel like buying a lady a bracelet is going to be a really beautiful idea for a Valentine's Day present. So don't buy a ring if you're not planning to engage to someone on this day, because it's going to be really confusing. When it comes to necklace, it's nice idea, but I feel like bracelets are really, really nice, and ladies can wear them every day, and every time she's going to look at her hand on her wrist, she's going to think about you. So that's something really nice. When you have a necklace, you can't really see it until you're going to see yourself in a mirror, or if it's very long necklace, then yes. But most of the time, those kind of classic necklace, you won't be able to see it all the time. But when you're wearing something on your wrist and you're going to look, a lady is going to look at it, she's every single time she's going to think about you. So this is just very, very nice and classic gift, and I think every woman would really appreciate something like that. With bracelets, don't go very, very crazy here. Go for either gold, silver, platinum, just something. If you don't have big budget, then silver is a really good option. But just go for something thinner, go something delicate, again more feminine, rather than something very, very big, because those very big bracelets, lady, she's not going to wear them every single day, but she can wear very like a gentle bracelet to work. She can wear it basically every time. Another thing is to buy some kind of trip, And that's obviously going to be for a lady and for a man. So this is going to be combined. You can buy some, you're going to buy something that you're going to have use as well. And obviously all depends on budget. Again, I'm talking more here about those kind of trips that you're going to rather more fly somewhere. And those, you can go for some kind of exotic, if you have a budget for that, you can go for something like a winter, skiing somewhere. But when it comes to those gifts, those trips, you don't really want to buy something that you're going to use it in September. You want to buy something that you're going to have time, you're going to go through your calendar, and you're going to actually check that you can, let's say in 2 weeks time, you can fly somewhere and go somewhere and enjoy, because you still want this to be a Valentine's Day present. You don't want this to be a birthday present or summer holiday present. You just want this to be for this occasion. So if you are able to do that, you have a budget for it, you have a time for it, because obviously you need to have free time and have a holidays day, then I would say romantic getaway is absolutely beautiful idea, and every lady is going to appreciate something like that. Because it's something adventurous, something that you're going to do together, something that you're going to have memories, beautiful memories for the rest of your life, and women love this kind of stuff. Just remember, don't put it very far away in your calendar. I would say maximum till middle of March you should use it. So don't do it April or anything further, because it's just not going to be Valentine's Day present anymore. Like, it's not going to have the same feeling. The best you can do is just do it in a week time, but obviously we all know it can be quite difficult. So up to, I think, middle of March you can still do it, and it's going to be as a Valentine's Day present. If you don't have this kind of budget to fly somewhere in some kind of romantic destination, you can still do it as a somewhere local, go to some kind of, do have like a, have a like a spa day for both of you, or just for a lady. So that's just up to you. If you feel like you want to join, or if you don't want to join, you can just buy her some kind of like a spa day. Or if you want to do it together, which is really really nice and romantic as well, then go together to a spa. Again, doesn't need to be on this day particular of Valentine's Day, but it's similar to getaway. So up to middle of March you should really use it to have this kind of feeling that it's day like it's still Valentine's Day present. So it's really nice if you go together, because it's again spending time together, connecting and all those stuff. So I really recommend you to do it together. But if you're really not in those kind of things, then any lady is going to appreciate to have a spa day. Well, who doesn't like to have a massage? Another little bit more material, I would say, present is to buy a bag. And yes, you heard me. Ladies love bags, and there's something about bags that it's still, I would say, considered to be a romantic gift, especially those more expensive ones. So this is the way you're going to appreciate your lady, by buying a little bit more expensive bag for her. And it all depends on your budget. Obviously, you can go for the top, which is Hermes, or you can go slightly lower, you can go for Chanel, you can go for Dior, you can go for anything. You need to really decide what is your budget, because if you know that you can spend £2,500 for a Chanel bag, then go for that. But if you know that that's way out of your budget, then that's okay. There are bags that ladies still going to appreciate, you know. We all know, if you know someone, then obviously ladies know what kind of situation you are, and they're not going to expect you to spend crazy money if they know that you don't have them. That's just normal. So there are bags, and I'm going to put again a list here, that you can buy a lady and it's going to be appreciated. But obviously if you know that she has a similar bag in her collection, then don't buy exactly the same one. You can always buy a different color, but I would focus more on those kind of beige, light pink, maybe black, because black is very versatile. But if you can go for those kind of like a pinkish and beige color, or even white, then it's going to be really really nice as well. So yeah, I've got a list for you. So those are bags, those are more or less price tags, so you can just basically choose whatever it's more convenient for you. But I'm sure if obviously she doesn't own any of those bags already, then she would appreciate to have another bag. And this is something I think a personal as well. Obviously if you know that your lady doesn't like a very light color, don't go for them, go for black, because it's very classic color and every lady needs black. even if the lady, she has already three black bags, she will need a fourth one, believe me. So if you're not sure about color, if you're not sure if she wears any light color, then going for darker is still okay. But as I'm saying, those beige, even like a pastel colors are very, very elegant, and we need those kind of bags. Let's just be honest, we need bags like this. Very classic are obviously flowers, and I think like flowers, but don't buy those kind of flowers from supermarket. If you can, try to buy them in a nice box, this kind of like a round box. Those are really, really beautiful, and women really appreciate something like that. If you don't have big budget, then I think it's better to buy few roses than red roses, rather than go for some kind of random flowers. You know, it is a special day, it is more about love, so roses are on point. If you know that your lady loves sunflowers, that this is her flower, then you can buy sunflowers, but here you just need to really know about her taste. If you're not sure, go for roses, because those are just more safe as well, but very, very romantic. And as I'm saying, flowers in a box, they will be really, really gorgeous. If you're going to buy cut flowers, like a just more standard packaging, then I would say minimum dozen will be really nice. Red roses will be gorgeous, because they just symbolize, red color symbolizes love, we all know. You can go for pink, you can go for white as well. And those white, it's more like a pure loft, you know, so there is obviously connection there. So when you're buying flowers, I want to just mention that sometimes lady might expect from you to have something else, and it doesn't need to be expensive, but because flowers are a little bit basic and they are very traditional, I would say that even buying something like a pack of a box of chocolate would be really appreciated. Just something to come with flowers, if that's just like my opinion. But if you feel like you're going to buy a really big bouquet of flowers in those kind of beautiful boxes, then I would think it's going to be enough. But obviously, you know, the person you are in relationship, and if they like more stuff, they are feeling that you need to be a little bit more generous, or are they going to be just fine when you buy those big flowers? Because for me, it would be personally enough, but some ladies might feel that at least something extra would be a little bit better. So even as I'm saying, box of chocolate or even a bottle of champagne, it's going to be still really, really nice, because you can drink this bottle together on the evening, and it's just going to be really lovely. Another option, if you have a skill or you are on a budget, then I feel like it's really nice to organize a dinner date at home. So you can do it at home, but you obviously need to prepare a little bit, have this kind of beautiful romantic atmosphere. So you need to buy some kind of flowers to put on the table. White, you need to buy or invest in white tablecloth, so it's all nice and clean and smart. You put nicely plate, you prepare everything, so she doesn't need to do anything. And in this way, she's going to appreciate that you put this effort. Even if you don't cook, then you can order takeaway, which is, I think it's okay. If you obviously cook, that's more effort, so it's going to be more appreciated. However, if you know that you're not cook at all, and it's no point to get food poison, then if you order takeaway, even I think a pizza, it's not going to be bad, honestly. It's already preparing this kind of setting for a lady, preparing a nice wine, because that's what you can do, choose a nice bottle of wine, then I think it's going to be really, really lovely. And those on the budgets are really great, and I'm sure that your lady is going to appreciate you for trying to impress her and trying to add this kind of effort. So it's not only that you give her flowers and here you go, that's it. No, making this kind of dinner, even on a budget, even if you're going to order takeaway, it's going to be really, really nice, because it just shows you effort. And for women, that's what is important, that men actually give something from himself. It's not only about money, it's also about a spoiled woman, but with his time, with his attitude. So those are very, very important. What it comes with ladies is that we are more, I would say, we like those kind of like presents that represent our memories, that if you put effort to create something like this, then we're going to appreciate that. We're going to know that, oh, he put really time, he prepared this for us. It's not only that he click bought us something and that's it, you know? No, we like to have effort from men. We like to feel spoiled, but with also attention. So another gift might be a surprise, but I feel like I would personally appreciate something like this. If I would receive a beautiful classic, let's just put the word classic here because it's important. Let's say black, maybe leather, or white leather, even better. Or red leather if you find one. Like a book with your pictures, so like a photo book, but not with crazy pictures around, very classic. So one picture on one page, doesn't need to be stretchful. It can have some kind of beautiful quotes that you both remember, maybe something that you said that day. And those kind of, and I mean, that's where the effort is going to show. If you're going to add something that you're going to actually, that you remember from that day, and you're going to write it down over there, and lady, she's going to open this book and she's see obviously the picture that you're all both together or with your family. And she's already going to remember that day because it was positive day, and she's like, oh, that's so lovely that you created that. But then she's going to read that this day I felt so much in love with you, or something on another picture that I was never so much happy like this day. This day created such a beautiful memory, so I'm always going to remember that. Another, maybe some kind of quote that you both like. And this way she's going to really know that you put effort, that you really created something very, very special. And every day, every time she's going to have maybe a bad day, she's going to open this book and she's going to know, you know what, he's so lovely, he's so romantic, he's done it for me. And honestly, this is really nice present. I'm not telling you only to click put pictures on the quickest way you can do it, because that's not going to really cut. But if you add something personalized by, I mean, text, then it's going to be really, really lovely. And again, when it comes to cover, you don't want to a lot of pictures over there, a lot of some kind of text. The classic it is, the better. So either black, or you can have a picture on the cover, but just one picture, or maybe two pictures with some kind of gentle text, just very something classic looking on the cover. It's going to be more, it's just going to be nicer. Rather than have some kind of hard made of a lot of pictures, you know, it's just, that's going to be classic and elegant, and that's what we're looking here for. Another thing is to have some kind of experience together. So again, similar to those getaways, but this way maybe something for that particular day, you telling your partner that, okay, so today we're going to have something special, I prepare something special for you. You need to, I don't know, maybe finish your work 1 hour earlier or something. You need to obviously organize the logistic here. But maybe it can be a balloon flight or something. Those are everywhere, honestly, those are everywhere. It can be experience on a boat, if you have some kind of, if you're living in a country when that's possible. On a boat is really nice and romantic, especially if you prepare some kind of picnic, some kind of food with it, or if you can afford it, a chef who is going to cook for you. So there, obviously, everything depends on your budget, but a boat obviously itself can be expensive. So just saying, if you can go up, can you top that up, then you can have a chef who is going to cook for you both, and that's wow. But if you can't, preparing a picnic is going to be really lovely as well, honestly, because it's again your preparation, and we appreciate this kind of stuff. And you can have a, if you know your lady is more adventurous, like she likes those kind of camping stuff, even you can prepare beautiful, like a glamping, I would say more than camping, but and have some kind of even a fireplace on the evening, cuddle together, have a wine in those kind of metal cups, you know. But again, that's something for ladies that you know that your partner likes that. If someone is completely 5-star hotel, don't do that, because they're going to feel uncomfortable that they need to sleep somewhere outside. Again, that's just something that you need to consider, you know, you need to know your partner. Again, another thing, very romantic, helicopter fly. But with those kind of experience, you just need to be a little bit more careful, because ladies can think that he's going to propose. So it's just up to you, right? So if you feel like you are on the stage that it's just a beginning, then obviously she's not going to think that. But if you are mid in your relationship and you're going to do something like this and you're not going to propose, it's going to be okay. She might be a little bit like disappointed that there was no ring. But when you're going to actually propose, she's going to expect you to top that. So just be careful. But those experiences are beautiful, are really, really great. So I think, like, if your lady is a little bit more adventurous, then this kind of day as a Valentine's Day together, doing something memorable like this, and you're going to remember all your life that you had a flight in helicopter and someone organized that for you, that's really something you're going to remember. So yes, those are really great. And the last one, so that's our 10 position, I believe so, and this is more for your pleasure, really. Buying some kind of beautiful lingerie set, but those kind of romantic one. I wouldn't say something that is going to be just like a normal bra, normal pants, and no. You want this to be special, so you expect her, I would say, wear it on this evening. But you want this to be really, really nice, and maybe a satin gown, like a shorter one if you want, or slightly longer one. It's that's obviously you can choose something what you like. That's she's going to wear that for you anyway. So I hope so. But let's hope that she's going to wear that for you. But overall, you need to know her size. If you don't, if you're not really sure about her size and you are at home, you can just choose, check in her drawer, take a bra that you know she's wearing, and check what is the size over there. That's going to, everything's going to be there. Again, the same with pants. Sometimes you're buying sizes, you can buy them as a, not exactly, let's say 38B in size, but you can just buy it as a S, M, L. And obviously you need to know what kind of body your partner has. Is it more S, is it more medium, or is she a little bit larger, right? So that's just it. You need to know the size if you to actually, because you don't want to buy someone L and you know, and she's M, right? So it's just, you don't want to have this kind of mistake. But I think, like, woman can forgive, you know, because the gift already is there. Even if it's L, it's a little bit the bigger side, it's okay, you know. It's just, this is the lingerie that she's not going to wear every day, she's going to wear that tonight, right? So it's just preparing. So yeah, that was my 10 position. I think those are really nice and classic gifts. Some of them may be more adventurous than others, some of them more classic, like perfume, but any woman really appreciate perfume. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please leave it a thumbs up, and see you in the next one.